Well, here we are in sunny Amagar on the way down to the infamous T3B. Now, I hear you ask, T3B, what's that? T3B is a little town, maybe about an hour and a half, 2 hours out of Medellin, depending on the absolutely hideous traffic coming out of town, like there was today. Man, that was heavy duty, like 10 miles of solid trucks. Anyway, we're on the road now and we're heading down to the little town of T3B. T3B was the very first place I got a... No, a lie. It was the second place I got some work in Colombia with the mineral exploration gig. So I probably, first time I would have been to T3B would have been about 2008. And it's a nice, little, it's another little country town, yeah? So we're going to go down and we're going to see another coffee faker and have a wee look around the town. But the fame of T3B is that if, let's say if you were cheating on your girlfriend, who would do such a thing, obviously, your girlfriend didn't know, but your friends did. Back in the old days, what they used to say was, do you know where Albert is? And they would go, well, I don't know, but I think he might be in T3B. So the old joke being that basically, if ever anybody was in T3B, it meant they were cheating on the girlfriend. How nice is that? What a lovely little story. Now the other thing about T3B is T3B is a very old mining town. And there's a very old mine there called San Curo. San Curo is kind of like a big mosquito, yeah? And San Curo was such a big mine that they actually had their own currency. So they kind of printed their own money and stuff for the miners. So that's a little bit of background on T3B. I'm sure I'll give you a bit more when I'm in T3B. But at least we're out of the traffic now. Got some gas in the bike. So on we go down the road to T3B. So we've got the double T3B here. We've got the sign and the welcome to T3B sign ahead. Can't remember the last time I was here. Not 10 years ago. You tend to blast right past it, but I'm kind of looking forward to having a wee quiet weekend and we'll see what else we can run about and see in the T3B. Welcome to T3B! Well, we're not even close yet, it's a few clicks. It's a few clicks down the old back road here, to the B. Jesus! There he is. Just you and me in T3B. Thank you. Busto. Remember, this road's always good for a bit of a landslide. Well, it's the Andes in Colombia that isn't good for a bit of a Margarita. Margarita, what are you doing down that mina? Margarita, give us a look at your mina. Horses. Laughing boy, what are you up to, laughing boy? water. Maybe a wee bit of a view. A view of the bee. There she be, the bee. How's about that? Take a 40. So, there you go. Over behind me right there is the illustrious Pueblo of Titiribí. And this is just coming into town. So I thought I'd stop and have a wee look at the view across the valley. And then I thought I'd show it to you, because that's just the kind of guy I am. We're heading up to the Finca Torbellino. And we're going on the back of somebody else's bike. We're getting a moto taxi just for fun. And we will, of course, be recording that shiznit. Mira, esos jóvenes de Titiribí están riéndose de mí. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Ave Maria. But best of all, we got the transport today, man. This is squared away. This is the real deal. Yeah, man. Let's get on up to the farm. Woo-hoo! So what you reckon to this, folks? It's the moto taxi. I'm loving it already. No hills in Titiribí. Yes, it's a proper off-road now, boys and girls, in the moto taxi. 205cc's takes you where you need to go, boys and girls. Damn fine stuff, I say. Torbellino bugger. So here we are, folks, out in the wilds of Titiribí. Getting ourselves up to a point where we can set the drone off. Woo!
Andres Rojao. El banqueo.
Yeah.
Para construir.
No, perfecto. Se limpia eso. En 5 minutos y ya listo para construir. Well, we better say hello to George. Don George, tenemos que decir hola a ti.
Hola.
George is going to be the guy who's showing us around today. Vámonos, George.
La vista.
And down there is sunny Titiribí. So, let's get the drone out. See if we can lose it on the first day. Only joking, not gonna do that at all. And we're off. Now, I'm not great with this drone yet, as you'll see in the video, but I was lucky enough to get some tips from some very interesting experts who you might see a little bit of in the next video. So, this was a really cool view. I kinda hadn't expected the coffee to be in amongst the trees. And there's some old trees and there's some new trees and, well, it was a learning experience and you'll get to see more of that in the next video as well.
So, as I now remember, this is Finca San Luis that provides us with the coffee for Torbellini. You'll see more of that coming up too. Remember to like, subscribe, and leave a comment.